Good morning, Facebook. This is Lori coming to you live, and about the only thing I hear is that bank drive-through window going up and down. So people are still taking out cash. I know they are. We are here. We are closed for walk-in clients, but guess what? I am meeting people at the door and delivering their gummies. So here we are, guys. We made it another day. Amanda, are you working out with us today? Debbie, good morning, good morning. Let's wave to everybody. Let's flip this camera. Well, I'm gonna flip it in a second. All right, ladies, let's get this show on the road. This is what's happening today. So if you would take a screenshot of this, you will have no idea what this means because I talk in gibberish. I talk in riddles. I'm almost like, what's that guy? The Cat in the Hat? Dr. Seuss? I really do. So none of my workouts make any sense to anyone other than me. That's why I'm here to walk you through this today. Hello, Shari, how are you? Twice in 2 days, it's like I hit the jackpot. So this morning, we've got a little disco. We've got a little ABBA going on. We're gonna do a little routine here. Peggy, how are you? Thank you for joining. I just have to say, ladies, there may be gentlemen coming on. I am just having such a grand old time with this quarantine. I almost feel bad saying it. I am loving, number one, I am loving being a housewife. And I do not say that to be downplaying that term at all. Listen, I know it's a selfless job. Hello, Janet. You are my hero. I freaking love you, girl. It's taken me 50 years to become a housewife. And I said to myself, and I've always envied these women. Hello, Cindy. You better get your sneakers on because we're rolling. I'm just telling a little story because you know Lori loves to tell a story. I am having so much fun that it's taken me 50 years to become a housewife. I am sitting home with my two teenage children, cooking, cleaning, I'm doing laundry, I'm making homemade shit. I said it, I'm making homemade hand sanitizers, I'm making homemade face masks, I'm making all this stuff, and I am doing at least 1 hour of self-improvement a day. And I'm challenging all of you to that too. Listen, we're on the World Wide Web now. And I applaud all of you for getting up, putting on your sneakers, and doing this with me today. But I'm also challenging you here. What else could you be doing? What else could you be learning? Where could you be listening to podcasts or going on to YouTube channels or doing something for some kind of self-betterment, personal development, okay? So I want to challenge you, not only has this quarantine given us the opportunity to work on ourselves physically, and listen, guys, it's not real hard, is it? Like, if you have a fifth grade education, you could come on this broadcast right now and do what we're doing. You don't even need a fifth grade education, okay? The same holds true with all the information out there, guys. If anyone has ever done what you want to do, there's my favorite housewife now, Shannon. I was just talking about how much I love being a housewife. And I'm saying this with the utmost of love to all of you women who have stayed home and raised children and done all of the selfless jobs that you do every day. I am so enjoying that right now. So my rant right now, we should be up and warming up. So let's go. Everybody up. I already took a picture of the board. I will take another picture of it at the end of the workout. Today, my challenge to you is this, as we're working out. I want you to think about these questions because last night I had a group of amazing women on my wine, women, and wisdom call. We had a free call. We all drank a little wine. We did a little meditation. We chatted. And let me tell you, the amount of positivity that came out of that call last night, I realized there were women of all different ages on that call, and every single woman, I'm telling you, came away from that call sharing something positive that they have gained from this quarantine, okay? How many women were able to work on their businesses that didn't have the time to do it? How many women were able to clean out certain things in their homes that they weren't able to do? How many people were able to really engage in connecting with their loved ones? So, and being able to have healthy boundaries. Like every woman that came to that call talked about something that they saw as a blessing or a benefit of this. And I want you all to think about this too. How have you benefited from this quarantine? How have you been able to pull something positive out of this? Like Allie said to me, we're warming up. If you're not warming up, get up. Let's go, girls. Do what you gotta do. I don't care. Phone on. I didn't put my phone on do not disturb. Oh well. Let's hope nobody else calls me. Don't anybody call me right now. Wait till the end. My daughter and I were sitting there at the table yesterday, and I'm working on my computer because I'm doing a 30-day program. She's working on her computer. Joey's working on his. And she said to me, you know, Mom, I think this quarantine was meant for us so that we could all be together. Aww. Isn't that sweet? I was like, yeah. Whenever had we all had the time to sit here at the table together and do our work? Like, really? Like, what a blessing. So, I hope you are all getting something good out of this. I'm glad to see you're all coming and showing up here. Hello, George, how are you? I hope you're marching it out with us and not just watching. Elaine, how are you? Let's go. All right, so today, grab your little dumbbells, 5-pound dumbbells, or water jugs, or anything that has weight to it. Cans of beans. Oh, I didn't think about the contest for today. Yesterday, Val Petrangelo won with the can of beans in her closet. So, I'll think of something. All right, so here we go. Grab your dumbbells. So here we are, light dumbbells. Maybe 3 to 5-pound dumbbells. We're gonna start here. So we're gonna do our shoulders 3 different directions. We're gonna start with an upright row. So we're rowing. The tunes are playing. So if you wanna make this a little harder, you can add a squat and upright row, okay? So we're working on all 3 heads of the deltoid here. We have the front, the side, and the rear deltoid. So a nice round shoulder helps make you look leaner. If you put a little more shape to your upper body, listen, ladies, as we get older, I hate to say it, after the age of 30, you lose 0.5 pound of muscle every year. What that does is it slows your metabolism down, girls. You don't want that. So just do a little weight training. All you need is these 5-pound dumbbells. Ready, next one. Side raises, okay? If you want to add a squat, you can, up and down. Janet loves the squat. I do this for her. I do it for all of you, come on. Listen, I say this all the time. Your body is your vehicle. Everybody's all worried about their car, their house, their savings account. Your body is it, girls. Girls, guys, whoever's on this. Aliens, if you're not happy in your body, what good is it? Like, this is what you have. You came in with it, you're going out, you're leaving it. This is your vehicle, take care of it. Now more than ever. 2 more. Last one, take a break. From here, we're bringing the legs in. Front raise. How we doing, guys? Is the music sleepy? Alexa, skip. She shut the hell off. What a, Alexa, I'm telling you. Maybe I have to give her a raise. All right, we're here. Front raises. Hold on, I gotta charge her up. 3 more. 2 more. Take a break. Hold on, guys, grab your water. March it out. Betty Jo, how are you? How was your walk yesterday? I know, the good news is too, how about all the people we're seeing outside that are actually going outside and walking with their dogs and their children? How novel, right? All right, let's see if it goes back on. Okay, here we are, guys. Let me wave to my friends. Casey, how are you? Mary, how are you? Nancy, hello, hello. Betty Jo, do you have your dumbbells? Let's go. All right, so next exercise, biceps. How do I have this? Okay, so we have a three-angled approach here too. If you can, ready? Hammer curl, watch my grip. Wide curl, okay? Hammer curl, see I'm changing my grip every time? Wide curl. When you're lifting, you wanna always confuse the body, okay? If you do the same thing all the time, the body stops responding. So it's called muscle confusion, okay? You're challenging your body to think outside of the box, to do something a little different. Believe it or not, the reason why exercise is so good for you, not only physically but mentally, it's forming new synapses in the mind. So it's telling the brain to send these signals to different muscles. Stay low, don't stand up. I see people going like this in my mind. I can't see you. People think that I can see them, it's so funny. Okay, so everybody feeling this, their biceps? Take a break, come up. Last one, Alexa, louder. My speaker keeps giving up, hold on. Hold on, don't go anywhere. Okay, last bicep move. They should be tired, right? We're sitting low. Elbows are close to your sides. We're gonna take it out, tap, out. Stay low. Your heart rate should be elevated because you are using your legs. If you wanna come up and down, you can do that too. Okay, we're trying to keep this super simple but effective. You will sweat. If you stay with me, guess what? You will sweat. If you stay on, guess what? You will learn something. If you continue and do this whole workout with us, guess what? You'll feel better. That's all fact, okay? Or you could scroll through and not watch. It's up to you guys. What better time? What better opportunity than now to make your health your priority? Take it off the back burner, guys. There's nothing else but you out there. It's just you. You and your health and your immune function. So let's keep your rhythms going. Let's keep your body healthy. Two more. See, Lori doesn't, she doesn't count. So one thing I have to say is it's a shortcoming of mine. Okay, ready? Holding the dumbbells here. We're gonna go down for three and up for one. So watch me. So it's down, 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 up, toes. Ready? Down, two, three, up, toes. We got it? Up, toes. Very concentrated movement here, guys. Guys and gals. Okay, we're working on your legs. We're working on your core. We're working on your calves. Anytime you come up on your toes, right? And anytime that you are doing a lot of repetitions, you're encouraging the body to burn more stored fat. You're not going for bulk here, guys. You're going for strength, you're going for endurance, you want your heart rate up. Does anybody feel like their heart rate's coming up? Give me some hearts, drop me some ones in the comment below if you feel like your heart rate's up. Also, if you're watching live, please put live in the comments below. If you're watching on the replay, please hashtag replay. Thank you. I can see the hearts now. I can see them. Love you all. Okay, and also, I wanted to tell you, is it time to change? I think it is. All right, ready? Next one, plank dog. Right after this broadcast, I'm going on again, live, second live, where I'm going to do a guided meditation and angel card reading. What? Yes, I am. I'm trying to give away as much free stuff as I can in the next 30 days. I'm just blowing it out because, and I said this last night on the call, I am the person, march it before we get down because I want to explain this because if I don't say it, it's not going to come out. I am the person who loves to help. That's my job. I made a career of it. I help people. I fix people. I create programs and I fix situations and I coach people. I need people in my life. Right now, the hardest thing, the biggest suffering for me is not being able to be in rooms with people. I just had a woman come get her gummies. I had to stop her at the door. I'm like, don't come any further. Hold on. And I had to run it out and, you know, it's just like I am a communal person. I love to build community. I love to bring people together. And the fact that I cannot be in the presence of human beings right now is killing me. So I said, how can I be in the presence of people? How can I help people now when people need it most? And I said, I'm just gonna use Facebook. I'm going to come on every day and give away what I do. And hopefully, if I can help one person today, my job is done. So I hope that this is helping you. If it is, please hit that little share button in the corner of your phone and share this to your timeline so I can be exposed to your friends and family and help them too. All right, public service announcement over. We're going planks. Guys, who loves a plank? No one. No one. If you said yes, you're a liar. No one loves a plank. That's like loving a burpee. Are you crazy? Is there anybody out there that actually loves a plank? I want to shake your hand because I don't, okay? Contrary to public belief, I don't love any of this shit. You know what I love? I love the way it makes me feel after. I don't love doing it. All right, so watch. That's straight talk with Lori. Plank. Dog. So stretch. Shift to a plank, shift to a dog. Hold on, the mop is going up. Oh, Carrie's gotta be on. There's 900 hearts, and I think that is my girlfriend Carrie, because she is the closest thing to Tigger from Winnie the Pooh that there is. I'm telling you, look at that. If that isn't cute, I don't know what it is. I have to look at who it was. That's all right, they're done now. All right, so watch me, guys. Plank, dog. Plank, shift slowly, guys. Dog, okay? Now, if that feels too hard, just hold a plank, okay? If this feels too hard, go onto your forearms. All right, we're here. Whatever you wanna do, we're working the core, we're working the abs. Good. From here, since we're on the floor, let's do a couple more abs. I know Debbie loves abs, she's on. She loves to work her core. So here we are, we're down. Oh, my spine just cracked. Heels are up, okay? We're gonna up and over. Guys, I love you, the hearts, thank you, thank you. Thank you for your appreciation. I hope I don't have a hole in my pants. That would be horrific. My son, Joey, I swear, I was dying. He was showing me a video yesterday about a woman who was on a Zoom call with her class, and she forgot she was on camera, and she went into the bathroom and used the bathroom on the camera. Listen, I have a similar story. Carrie knows the story. I was on a Zoom call a little while ago. Totally forgot. You know how you're not paying attention? March, guys. Now, during the cardio break, anything you want to do, you're marching, you're jogging, you're jacking. Oh, she looks like a crazy lady. So anyway, I did this personally. I did this a couple weeks ago. I was on a Zoom call with another company that I work with, and we were doing a training, and I'm getting ready for bed. So Carrie, my friend, tells me, oh, I take my phone in the shower all the time. I just put it up on the shampoo thingy. Oh, what a great use of time. I can listen to my videos, my broadcasts, while I'm in the shower. So I do it. I forget I'm on camera. I don't know how many people saw this. The birthday suit, I don't know. They didn't tell me. And I thank you for not telling me if you saw me naked, because listen, even the Chris Flickinger barely gets to see this thing naked anymore. But anyway, I could see how it happens. Carmen, are you working out with us? Are you just sitting there? Don't. Mike, how are you? So if you were one of those lucky people that was on the Zoom call with me, you caught me. You caught me in the shower. Please don't forget, when you're on a Zoom, the video sees you too. I cannot see you on Facebook. If you're sitting on the couch now picking your nose, I can't see it. If we're in a Zoom call, guess what? I can see you. So don't bring your phone in the shower. Public service announcement number one. Morgan Mitchell, are you up? Come on, Morgan, let's go. You just got here for the second round. Here we go, guys. Shoulders. Get low, horse stance from here. Lateral raises. Okay. Anybody want anything specific today? Like, can I help anyone with anything? Do you need to stretch anything? Is anybody feeling any pain anywhere when we do our cool down? Eh? Nah? Type it in. I know you have dumbbells in your hands right now. Three more. Two more. Last one. Good. From here, arms down. Get low. Upright row. We're just repeating that whole thing we did the first time. I'll give you another picture at the end. Okay, we're working on the shoulder. Three different areas of the shoulder. The front, the medial, and the rear deltoid. Always throw the legs in there to get a little more burn going, right? Who's with me? Three more. Two more. Last one. Take a break. The challenge today, who has the most toilet paper in their house? I want to know. This could cause a riot. Who has the most toilet paper in their house? Let me know. How many rolls? For a prize, we have free prizes for the people who participate in this. Front races, guys, you're down in a ski squat. You're low. Like, how much toilet paper does a person need? Don't people realize that you could use a tissue, you could use a napkin? It might not be the best situation. You can use a coffee filter. You can use a water bottle. You can get in the shower. We still have one in water, guys. I remember when we used to pick blueberries as kids, my grandmother would say, use a leaf. You want to talk about an ineffective way to wipe yourself, a leaf? That thing slides all the way up your back. Guys, don't use a leaf. Whatever you do, use the tissue. Use the paper towel. Okay, is that done? Am I over it? All right, ready? Biceps. How we doing, peeps? Hello, hello. I lose this one down to six. What do you mean by that, Janet? I'm down to six. Oh, 6 pounds? Is that what you mean? All right, ready? Hammer curl, wide curl. So let's get low. Ready? Hammer, change your grip, wide. You're still sitting down. You're low. See, I'm sitting. Okay. Hammer. Why? What's everybody making for dinner tonight? I want to know. Share. Joey is making dinner for us tonight. I put everybody on a different night. Even though I'm a housewife now, I'm still making them earn their keep. He's making a pork roast and a deer roast. He has two different crock pots going. So I don't know what I'm walking into a little later, but he's been cooking like chef rocketing up a storm. Allie, listen, when we have to get Allie's dinner, it's probably going to be mac and cheese, which I can't eat because I'm lactose intolerant. So I might really lose a lot of weight on the night that Allie has to cook. But hey, we're all having fun, right? And I don't know, once this weather breaks, guys, I am going to do workouts in the parking lot. Oh yeah, I said it. I'm doing workouts in the parking lot. I'm inviting all of you down here. Bring your dumbbells, stay 6 feet away, and we're walking, and we're doing drills, and we're running, and we're doing push-ups on the wall, and we're jumping up and down off the curb. All kinds of fun stuff, right? We're getting it done. We don't have to, we can social distance. We could be outside, right? Nobody told us not to. All right, there we go. Pulse squat, ready? We are ripping through this. Down for three, up for one. Toes are out, you're holding your dumbbells. Down, two, three, up, tippy toes. Down, two, three, up, tippy toes. Keep going, guys. I can't wait to see how much toilet paper you guys have in the house. It's amazing, isn't it? This is what we've become. Toilet paper hoarders. Oh God. So on a different note, if anybody is struggling right now, I am doing another live broadcast right after this where I'm going to be doing a healing meditation, complete polar opposite of what we're doing here. We're not bouncing off the walls. We're going to be relaxing, we're going to be breathing, we're going to be setting our intention, we're going to be getting a little clarity. I'm going to be pulling angel cards for everyone and giving you a little reading. It's gonna be super fun. And I just feel it's so important to let people know they're not alone right now, okay? And listen, I always say that every day is a different opportunity for you to be in the barrel. And we talk about this in my house. We joke about it. Hello, Kelly. How are you? Thanks for joining us. Pork chops and applesauce. Janet. When we talk about our day in the barrel, cardio. Come on, guys. March, jack, jog, jump, whatever you want to do right now. Move, okay, as I continue to talk at you. When it's your day in the barrel, it means it's your turn the time. Jeff. How's your neck? We're going to do some neck stretches to cool down for Mr. Jeff. He's one of my all-time favorite people on the planet, and I can't help him with his stiff neck right now, and it's killing me because I know I can help him, but I physically cannot put my hands on him. So I'm going to show everybody some neck stretches that we can all do together to help Mr. Jeffrey. Let me wave at Jeffrey. Jeff, that means you have to stay till the end. So what does it mean if it's your day in the barrel? I say it means that it's your day to do your flip out. All of our friends, all of our family has having moments, okay? When you're having emotional breakdowns, when you're feeling physically not well, and it's our job as human beings to meet people where they are and help them move through whatever situation they're going through. It's not our responsibility, and remember when I say this, to fix anything. If my daughter comes to me and she's having a meltdown, it's not my job to fix her. It's my job to be there, to observe her, to listen to her, to tell her I understand how she's feeling, to acknowledge that I feel compassion for her. I don't have to fix it. I can't fix it. Right now, she's where she is. All we can do to help our fellow person is observe them, give them support, give them compassion, and ask. If you see an obvious solution, you guys better be jogging. You better not be sitting down right now. I'll be pissed off. Ask. If you have an obvious solution, you say, here are the words. Would you like my input? If they say no, zip it. Guys, sometimes people don't want a solution, okay? Sometimes people have to be in their shit for a while. And this whole quarantine is giving us so much opportunity to sit in our shit so that we can see where we want to be. The contrast is the blessing, guys. If you're able to get something out of this and say, oh, I don't like this that I'm seeing right now. Well, tell me, what do you want? I don't know, Lori. I just know I don't want this. Well, do me a favor. Do yourself a favor. Tell me what this is that you really want. I know you don't want this. What do you want? And get really crystal clear on this. And guess what? Every one of you will blast out of this quarantine with new passion and new purpose. And you're gonna set shit on fire. Can I get some thumbs on that one, please? Because I know you're all marching, you got your phones in your hands. Or did you all go away? No, you're all still there. So let me know, air jump. Betty Jo's doing some air jumps. Beautiful, thank you, peeps. All right, guess what, guys? I stalled long enough, we have planks again. On the mats. Now say you're not a great planker. You can plank on a chair. You don't have to go all the way to the ground, okay? It has to do with the angle okay? So here we are, we're in a plank. It's just the top of a push-up, all right? Do we want to do some negatives? Huh, you know Lori can't stick to the program. Can she ever? Guys, that you train with me all the time, you know Lori doesn't stick to a program. So let's lower down slowly, ready? Five count. Five, four, three, two, down. Come back up on your knees, come back up on your toes. Together, drop it. Five, four, three, two, one. To your knees, to your toes. Yes, thank you guys, I see the love. Knees, toes. Now say that's hard for you. Okay, this is a modification. Five, four, three, two, one. Back up, ready? Five, four, three, two, one. Back up, how we doing kids? Come on, a couple more. Five, four, three, two, flat. Knees, back up. One more. Five, four, three, two, curb plop. That's it. All right, on your back, guys. Come on. On your back, we did it. Two times through. I want you to do it one more time if you're feeling froggy. We did 30 minutes, peeps. Let's stretch. How we feeling? Everybody happy? Are you all glad you joined us? Okay, so, can everybody see me? Knees up, arms overhead. We're gonna come up, reach for your heels. Come back, arms overhead. If you want to grab your dumbbell, you can. Okay, breathe. Look at this, 30 minutes. We got a workout in, we're feeling better. We got a little motivation. We hung out with some friends. Everybody feeling this in your abs? Two more. Last one, hold it up. Hold, hold, hold. Good, release. Hands behind your head. From here, opposite elbow, opposite knee. Opposite elbow, opposite knee. Slow. If I see you going fast, I can't see you. It's not the Zoom call, don't freak out. I cannot see anybody. Okay? Don't go fast. Control it. Four more. Three more. Two. Take a break. Let's do some bridges. Stretch out the hips a little bit. So we're gonna lift. Okay? These are my favorite. Don't let the hips touch the floor. You could be reaching for your heels here. You might feel a nice crack in your back here. How we doing, everybody? We good? Don't leave, it's almost done. Stay with us. The cool down is just as important. Two more. Take a break. I know everybody wanted a yoga stretch at the end, guys. Here it is. Here it is for all of you. I'm gonna do a little yoga. Who's still here? Oh my God, they're jumping, they're jumping. Jeffrey, are you still here? Do I have to stretch the neck? Anybody tight anywhere that you want me to do a specific stretch for you? I have 20 rolls. Who is that? All right, guys, here we go. Just a super basic yoga cool down. Let me turn off this fan. It's too much. Too much. Lori's getting chilled. Okay. Grab a sip of water if you need it. I think Morgan may win the toilet paper challenge. Shari's got 19 rolls. Morgan's got 20. Before all this mess. Morgan, you're one person. How much poop happens in this house? One freaking person. Huh, Morgan Mitchell wins with 20 rolls of toilet paper. Oh my God. All right, ready? From here. Let's kneel down. This is yoga for the beginner. If anybody is scared, don't be. This is super easy. Anyone can do this, don't be scared. Okay, so we're starting with the left knee forward. The right knee is bent, okay? from here, I just want you to start shifting your weight forward and back, okay? Super easy, okay? We're just trying to open up that right hip flexor, okay? If you can, bring the arms up alongside of your ears. Now, if you had a mirror, you'd probably look like this. You're pulling it up, pulling it back, looking up. Stretch, breathe. Good. Switch lead feet. Right foot comes forward. This is yoga light. So just push forward and back. This is for the person whose neck doesn't even have a yoga mat. Never. Yoga. This is for the person who doesn't even know what the heck that word is. It's just stretching. Okay? Basically, we're stretching the body. Okay, ready? We're gonna lean forward again. Inhale, push forward, look up. Opening the chest, opening the neck, opening that left hip. Good. From here, let's come up to standing. Left foot forward. Let's do that same thing standing now. Your feet are wider apart, as if you're standing on train tracks. So you're not on a parallel bar, you're not on a beam, you're on train tracks. One foot is to one side and one foot is to the other side of the mat, okay? So from here, bend that front knee, reach up again. Back leg is straight and you're stretching and you're breathing. Good. Excellent. Switch lead feet. Right foot is forward, left foot is back. Okay, this is your warrior. Inhale, exhale, bend that front leg and breathe. Good, take a break. Everybody knows balance is my thing. Balance, who wants to try to balance? If you say no, it's because you have bad balance, you need to work on it. The only way it's gonna get better is if you do it. Okay, ready? So let's work on a tree pose. Okay, so what I want you to do, get yourself grounded on your left leg, okay? Put all of your weight on that left leg. Focus here. Find a focal point, something on the wall that's not moving. Okay, so you're gonna start either in kickstand, you're gonna bring the leg up alongside the knee, or all the way up into the thigh, okay? Whatever feels comfortable. It's a little hard to do this with your shoes on. You might wanna hold onto a chair or something, okay? And from here, you're either standing or you're reaching your arms up. And you're breathing. This is a tree pose. Definitely easier to do without shoes on. Okay, other side. Everybody has a dominant side. Look, Lori can't even stand on this leg. So, you're just getting grounded. Imagining all of your energy going through that leg, taking it to a kickstand, all the way up to the knee, or all the way into the thigh. Whatever feels comfortable for you. Hands at heart center. Breathe, extend up if you can. Look at a focal point that's not moving. Good, release. All right, guys. For Morgan Mitchell, hold on. We're picking the prize, don't go away. Don't go away. Let's see what I have in this little bag for Miss Morgan Mitchell. That's it. Hold on, I'm stocking the bag right as we speak. Stocking as we speak. Okay. So, let me make sure though that 35, son of a gun, Debbie's got 35. Morgan, you didn't win shit. I didn't win. No, you didn't. Back to working at home. Bye, Betty Jo. Thanks for joining us. Share this to your timeline, please, Betty Jo, so all of your friends could have a nice workout today. Yeah, I say the 35 wins it. 35 rolls of toilet paper awarded to Debbie. Janet's got, yeah, 40 rolls. I know. All right, so my dear Debbie,
Debbie, you get to pick out of the grab bag of Lori's Wellness Loft. Now listen, Val got something I couldn't put in the mail yesterday, so I put it on the side for her. She got a nice eye pillow. I'm not putting it in the mail, I'm sorry. When we open back up, you come get. So Debbie, you get to pick from a beautiful lavender eucalyptus sachet. Did I say that right? If you put this in the microwave, oh my God, it smells so good. I'm coming over for Debbie. It's beautiful. This smells amazing. Or you could just put it in your underwear drawer, or you could put it in your car. Like, it's really nice on the dash of your car, so when the heat comes on, it smells like eucalyptus and lavender, and it's all natural. If you could see that, it's all just flowers. This thing is beautiful. Love this. Okay, so you could pick this, or hold on, don't go anywhere, Debbie. There's more. Or you can have a beautiful body scrub. This is a body scrub. It's all natural. Feels really good. You go in the shower, put it on your body dry, add water, and then scrub. Your skin will be baby smooth. Smooth. Number two. Number three is the favorite is the gummy. It's the CBD Bee Bliss gummy. I love these girls, and how I say, Shari, you're so cute. I am doing the best that I can to support any local business right now. These ladies are right here. They're probably a couple miles up the road. They make these themselves. They make balms, oils, and gummies. And let me tell you, you all know I feel like a broken record. My hip has been killing me. I have been putting their balm on my hip, and it is helping me so much to get through this until this inflammation goes down. So when I eat the gummies though, guys, I sleep like no other. I don't even wake up to pee. So, Debbie, what are you going to choose? Is it going to be the gummy, the lavender eucalyptus sachet, or the scrub? One, two, or three? Let me know what you want. I think Debbie may be gone. But anyway, she is our winner today. I will see you all in about 15 minutes for a meditation. Please share if this was helpful, and I'll see you again tomorrow morning.